All right, kids, Halloween, it's October, everything's all spoopy. Let's put on our costumes for the new Bronies Rat. Yeah! All right, another Bronies Rat. Hey. If you're ever down on your luck, remember, I'm a guy wearing a Sailor Moon outfit, watching My Little Pony, and calling myself a professional brony. Alright? Can't get much lower than that.
Hey guys, it's me, Rainbow Dash, aka Best Pony. 20% cooler, 10 seconds flat, and other things Rainbow Dash would say.
Hello? Little Shy isn't available for this reaction, so I'll be taking his place. I'm inconspicuous background pony number 83. Let's do this.
So this is a surprise. I had no idea there was a new Equestria Girls movie out, but I can't wait to watch it.
Da-da. 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 I'm a shark. I couldn't find a dolphin costume, but I found a shark one. I do have my dolphin puppet, though.
Team Rocket's blasting off again.
You all thought you were here to watch a Bronies react to Equestria Girls. Or in fact, I'm just here to exploit more Zootopia in your faces. It's called a hustle, sweethearts.
All right, cool. Halloween time, super spoopy in here.
Yeah, so I can't wait to see this Everfree Northwest video they keep talking about.
Twilight?
Yeah.
It's the Legend of Everfree. Everfree Northwest is a convention.
The champ is in the house. Macho Cat does the savage. Let's watch him.
Well, here we are. Another Bronies React to the ill-advised Equestria Girls movies.
I'm actually looking forward to this one, because every time I see something I don't like, I'm going to take off a piece of this armor, which is extremely hot and heavy, and I'm expecting to be fully out of this thing within the first 4 minutes. Let's start the show.
Say off the bat, I'm not wearing my back piece or my shins or shoes, and I could say that that's because it was extremely difficult to put on and it's really hot in here, but since I'm trying to follow the rules, I'm just going to say it's because I automatically hate that they made a fourth Equestria Girls movie.
Looks like I'm here for a Bronies React. What's a brony? A brick pony?
Where's the movie?
And for everybody at home who's wondering how we got back onto this series.
We're just as surprised as you are.
Oh, that's better.
Now, how am I going to start this? There we go.
Hey, yeah, I want to shoot, baby.
I know what you're thinking. Whose did I have to get on Bronies React? Well, it's a long story, but the short answer is pretty much everyone who's ever been on Bronies React. Yeah, that was a long weekend. Anyway, enough quoting my movie. Let's see what's worth quoting in this shit.
No, it can't be. It isn't true.
Four Equestria Girls movies.
Now we will look into her dreams.
Not a fourth movie!
Search your feelings, Twilight. You know it's to be true.
No, not a fourth movie, no! No! Oh, thank God, it was just a dream. Wait a minute. Oh, motherfucker!
Boy, for someone who knows magic exists, there's a lot of science stuff going on in Twilight's bedroom.
How did you get in my house?
I can't believe I overslept.
I can't believe it's not butter.
I can believe I overslept. I do that a lot.
Me neither. That's not like you.
It's not like you to sleep in past 6 a.m.
Don't you have a super annoying alarm clock that goes
Yeah, she's called Pinkie Pie.
Yeah, and this is no joke. I seriously wake up to this every night.
Pack a muffin and a picture Rainbow Dash.
If we were going to the moon, I'd insist she packed an evening gown. One never knows, darling.
Somebody call Elon Musk because I am ready for Mars.
Am I the only one who's already having the issue where I'm trying to remember which Twilight and which Spike we're looking at here? Man, did they screw things up in my head.
Let me just get changed.
In front of everyone.
Oh god, Twilight's an Alcorn! Wait, nope.
Midnight Sparkle!
Do they legit just know what she's called, Midnight Sparkle? I don't remember if they actually called her that in the last movie.
I know, they're all dead.
This is actually a really cool opening.
Well, that escalated quickly.
Like all that digitizing and everything, that's neat. That's really cool.
This time, I won't stop until I have all the magic!
And your little dog, too!
Wake up!
Twilight, stop! The bus isn't even into Vietnam yet.
Normally I'd be complaining about the cliche dream sequence, but it actually does a good job at setting things up and establishing Twilight's struggle and forcing the audience to ask questions we hope to have answered by the end. Never thought I'd say this, but good job so far, Equestria Girls?
Alright, time out. Okay, now who has a dream about sleeping in after you've already woken up?
So, is the villain in this one schizophrenia?
Can't stop, silly!
Hey, it's nice that they let Pinky on the regular bus this time.
I'm fine.
That's really convincing. Here's a tip, guys. If a girl says, I'm fine, they're not fine.
Sleep on marshmallow pillows!
Sleeping in the middle of the woods on a bag of marshmallows is a bad idea. Pinky's gonna get her face eaten by critters.
We're almost there, but before we arrive, we just wanted to say how proud we are of you for raising enough money to go on this class field trip.
Attention students, I look weird.
Seatbelts, everyone!
Seatbelts, everyone!
What money? What did you need fuel?
Wait a minute. If you two are there, then who the hell's driving the bus?
For a second, I thought Celestia was driving. I was gonna have to take off a piece of armor.
When we were your age, we made some of our favorite memories in these woods.
Luna.
I see what you did there.
We had so much sex.
Some of her favorite memories.
Flash is sitting by himself. Good.
Who's excited for Camp Everfree?
I'm excited.
Yeah, sex! This is just one big commercial for Everfree Northwest. Is it just me? How did you guys pull that off?
Yes.
Can we drink it every time Applejack talks?
Yes.
The way this bus is bouncing reminds me of those stupid wheels on the bus videos on YouTube that, for whatever reason, have like a billion views.
No, bad foot. We hate Equestria Girls. Stop tapping.
This reminds me of that Five Goes West song.
Looks like someone didn't have the budget to animate an entire bus full of kids singing the My Little Pony version of Ring of Fire.
I'm gonna pause right here, and I'm gonna take off my helmet, because this is the first thing I don't like about this movie, also because it's getting hot. I was actually cast to sing in this, but then I couldn't do it. Still, that's okay, because something better came up.
Let's see, I can make a joke about the prevalence of typos in the show, about Hasbro's strictness on trademark laws, and, oh, here's one. No one can remember how to spell the names of background characters.
What is this intro song, like Mumford & Sons?
It's a very Mumford & Sons intro, don't you think?
Is this the first opening we haven't had some crazy psychedelic circles intro with a lot of circles in it?
Hey!
So do you guys think that Ashley Ball and Andrea Libman make twice as much as Tara Strong? Since they voiced two ponies?
Isn't Camp Everfree just beautiful?
I swear that that bus has its eyes closed so tight.
Adorable whipping creatures too? Specifically squirrels. More specifically, so I can chase them.
Squirrel!
I'm sorry, Spike in a hat? Adorable. I love it.
I'm just after some R&R.
Voice that part of the movie again. Character introduction!
We fought three evil sirens who tried to hypnotize everybody with their singing, one ridiculously competitive rival school, and two demon friends!
And there's our recap. You didn't need to watch the first three movies.
Two demon friends actually ain't that bad. I mean, have you ever watched Inuyasha or Yu Yu Hakusho? He and Kurama are the coolest ones.
These stories were fucked up.
Hopefully this movie is just like the Lohan Parent Trap, where we're gonna have a strip poker game. Yeah? Yeah? They had that. On the Disney Channel!
No offense.
Oh, fuck!
Oh my gosh, are you seriously still doing the no offense thing?
We're still doing that? Guys, we're still doing that? Come on!
No offense, but you're a big fat ugly idiot.
Well, Pinky, the Macho Cat is very offended right now. Very, very offended.
No offense triggers me. I hate it. And for that, I finally take off this ridiculously heavy chest piece.
You'll get used to it.
You'll get used to them just passively mentioning that they were almost killed by you.
They're all about legs.
Have you seen Celestia?
No, I've seen her legs though.
I think we should have a count every time we do a raunchy joke.
That's a good idea.
Okay, chalk one up.
See if we got the little machine that goes ping.
Yup, I love the machine that goes ping.
It's gonna be nice getting away to a place where we don't have to worry about that kind of stuff.
That's what you think.
Wow, from behind, Octavia looks like the chick from The Ring.
Here you go, Twilight.
Hide your waifus, he's back.
It's Flash, right?
Yep, that's me. And you're you. And we don't know each other very well. Cool story, bro.
Go away!
All your A-Lamau's are belong to Harambe Lit, fam. Look how hip I am.
Ha! That was a really cool story, bro. Ha ha ha. Really cool.
Ooh! Smooth, bruh!
Wow, good job, awkward brony.
Dude, this guy wants to get his dick wet so badly.
He lost his waifu and he's going through withdrawal.
Race, I hope kids don't watch this show of yours.
See, that's kind of depressing. You got Flash, who loves Twilight, but really he's in love with the pony version of Twilight. He's a closet brony.
Flash is a grown man in love with horse girls. Probably just wanted to see her naked.
And you know what? In sympathy for Flash, even though he and I fight, I'm gonna take off these leg pieces.
Oh my gosh! That!
Oh, I really just did that because they were eating into my thighs. How does Master Chief wear this thing?
She's a pony princess?
Uh-huh.
Flash kinda had a thing for her.
Oh.
I love how this human Twilight just does not know Flash. It's great.
He had a little thing for her.
I'd recommend getting a restraining order. Or a gun. Whichever's more reliable. So yeah, a gun.
If you could start heading to the courtyard, that would be rad!
Jeez, I haven't heard fake enthusiasm like that since the opening ceremony at BronyCon.
I'm Gloriosa Daisy, your camp director!
Gloriosa, I am awaited!
Bullets from the bullet farm. Once again, I salute my Imperator Furiosa.
Think of me as your
new villain. I mean bad guy. I mean counselor. I mean villain. Phew, nailed it.
I will also be your camp counselor, your guidance director, and antagonist for the rest of the film. Thank you.
Think of me as that awesome guy. Who should always be invited to fun things?
I think I blocked Timber on Facebook.
It basically what they're hearing is, hey everyone! Awesome guy!
Like your girls' pillow fights.
Well, you know what's fun? Massacres! I'll make sure to invite you to one of those.
That's my thing!
I call new Twilight Crush. No Twilight left behind!
And it's me, the cool guy.
Cool guy? He looks like a fucking overgrown Oompa Loompa.
You're free to do whatever you like here.
As long as it's rated G.
Except hike near the rock quarry.
That's where the elephant graveyard is.
You must never go there, Simba.
Yeah, but you know that once you say something's off limits, it becomes that much more tantalizing. I only went the places my parents told me not to go. In fact, I was so predictable, they told me not to go where they actually wanted me to go. So, is choice real?
So what activities will make this the very best week of your lives ever?
Forced labor.
Archery, of course. Tetherball, naturally.
Rainbow, stop being an activity hog.
Wrestling.
Come on, let's do some American activities. Frickin', you know. Sleeping. This is a bed. Well, those are my stuffed animals.
Arts and crafts.
Ooh, I do make a mean sugar cookie.
She makes one mean sugar cookie, and the rest of them are pretty nice.
Early morning nature walks.
Don't forget your snacks on that nature walk there, Fluttershy. Snap no Slim Jim.
A fashion show?
Rarity, do you do anything that is not fashion related?
Oh wow, a fashion contest. Really breaking the mold of your character, huh, Rarity?
Because fashion is my only character trait. Everything I do is fashion. I can't talk about anything that is not related to fashion.
I design the most fabulous camp looks.
Don't worry, Rarity. I'm sure you'll make the most fabulous outfits ever.
I'll be taking requests the rest of the time you're here.
Play Freebird.
To do anything you need.
I know what Twilight would like to do. Him. Thank you. I'll be here for the next however much longer this video is. I can't be that meta.
Ooh. Booty. No. Locked on.
Did Flash not work out that bad that we had to actually bring in the other Twilight to pair her up with another guy?
Come on, Twilight. You deserve a better love story.
Twilight has another love of interest. I almost said life interest.
I wonder how Gabe's taking this.
Oh, for crying out. Love it. First son of a... This is gonna freaking suck for Flash! What kind of mixed feelings must that guy have? The only thing I can even imagine that would be remotely similar to that is if you fall in love with a girl, she dies in a car wreck, and then you realize she has an identical twin sister who doesn't know who you are and starts to fall for another guy. Except worse. Poor freaking Brad.
Then you thought wrong. Anyone else picking up on a little tension between Gloriosa and her brother?
No, but I am picking up on some really weird facial patterns.
Well, they are siblings.
Oh yeah, it's like something's going on between them or something.
Every year, campers work together to create something useful.
I don't actually need the mic, it's just a prop. I'm just as loud when I'm talking in the mic as when I'm talking away from it.
The sundial was our year's gift.
Even though some people thought it was a little impractical since a sundial can't be used at night.
Wow, we got Luna throwing shade at Celestia.
Luna is really smart.
And salty.
A little repressed anger there, Luna.
They should have made a moon dial then, because the moon works just like the sun.
Setting it up for the pay-per-view at the end of the week. I like your style.
Dang, Luna, would you like some pepper with that salt? But seriously, could this be foreshadowing? Maybe Nightmare Moon is a thing that hasn't happened in the human world yet. Equestria Girls 5. I'm calling it.
Speaking of leaving things behind, now's the time when we give out tent assignments, so you can leave your heavy bags behind.
That's so funny.
You see this boy winking? You think I don't know what you're doing? A boy at camp with all these pretty girls? I mean, I get it because Human Fluttershy is there, but look at you with your freaking pervert eyes looking at all these girls. Something up with that.
Getting their assignments from Timber. Guys, you're with me!
Excuse me. Where did the Apache attack helicopters go?
Yay! Yay, I get the labor camps!
Ah! You have the Hungarian horntail.
Aquamarine. Me too!
I always knew they were cut from the same gemstone, if you know what I mean, since they have the same voice actress.
I got amethyst.
Me too.
I got Steven.
Nope, too obvious.
Yeah!
You're better than that, Jordan.
Yeah, but they're mostly blue. That's why they're named after the Latin word spherus.
Oh, wow, you're so smart. Maybe that's why you're a frickin' camp counselor instead of doing something with your life.
Ah, nerd flirting. It's like reading a slash fic about two encyclopedias.
Oh, Twilight, you're such a nerd!
Don't worry, Twi. I'll pick a card for you. Ooh, it's the Friends with Benefits tent. What? It's a joke! It's a joke!
This is a conversation that should literally be happening with Mod Pie.
I'll give you the down and dirty about rocks and minerals.
Did you know that sapphire tent is the best one?
No. Why is that?
Because you're in it.
Oh, I bet you say that to all the campers.
Yeah, they're gonna bang.
The thirst is real.
Ooh! Smooth, bruh!
I bet you say that to all the campers. Not true. Only the ones I want to bone.
Yep.
That was a really bad pickup line, guys. That was really bad. It was really bad. And I want to take off a piece of armor, but I only have 3 left before I have to start stripping.
But did you know that sapphire tent is the best one?
You're in the ruby tent? Ha! That's the worst one.
He basically just called the guy stupid. Jerk. You could do so much better, human Twilight.
Hey, look, I know both biceps is kind of slow, but I don't think it's fair to assume he has an extra chromium.
Why would you insult both biceps anyways? He's literally like 5 times your size. He could squish your head like a tomato can.
What?
Nothing.
Adorable.
Nope.
Aw, it was cute.
Sweetie pie.
I need something.
Filthy Rich!
Okay, I can accept that name as a pony, but as a human being, that name only works if you're starring in a Donald Trump porn parody.
Why does the Equestria Girls version of Filthy Rich look a lot like Ganondorf?
The only reason that I came here is to just show off my money.
I am the Republican candidate running for this here office.
I like this guy. He looks like he made his fortune off a small loan of 1 million bits.
Oh, really? I couldn't tell by his tie and his lapel pin and his gold bar belt buckle and his voice and his clothes and his hair.
He's just trying to make Camp Everfree great again.
I hope I can get started on my designs for the camp fashion show.
We're not even that far into the movie and we're already getting that hip action with Rarity's walk.
We're supposed to be roughing it.
Did you just say we're supposed to be rubbing it?
Even if we are in the middle of the woods.
I don't care if we're in the middle of Afghanistan. We are still girls.
Pinkie Pie is really the best sort of friend.
Why, one would consider oneself lucky to be wearing it. And now I'm starting to sound a lot more like David Attenborough. The female Rainbow Dash does sit-ups in the background while the female Pinkie Pie, distracted, holds onto her feet to keep her from falling backwards.
Rarity, you press.
Ooh.
Sunset, you don't need that flashlight to be terrifying. Do what you did in the first movie.
That was weird back there, right? With that guy, Filthy Rich?
You don't think it was weird back there when, you know, the music just started randomly playing when I turned on the flashlight, did you?
Nah, that's just incidental music.
No, Sunset. That was weird.
Her brother is pretty cute, though, huh?
I love the way he talks about my brain.
I never thought I would like her. Because she felt so, you know, such a forced character, but I really do. I love her character.
Blah, blah, blah. When are we gonna get a good promo out of this movie? I mean, come on, nobody's actually getting a button heads yet.
Now look who's trying to hide something.
No, I'm not!
Thirst meter rising!
Great, now the fandom has another Wi-Fi stealer. Wait, Wi-Fi? What? Damn typos.
Everyone from CHS has been really nice and accepting. Especially considering what happened at the Friendship Games.
Because they like your ass.
That wasn't your fault.
Sure, it wasn't her fault she tried to commit genocide. Everyone has bad days now and again.
It wasn't your fault you just succumbed to peer pressure. So it was your fault.
You guys come in or what?
I mean, we would be if you'd give us some privacy. Shut up, you were thinking it! You were all thinking it!
Jeez, we've hardly even touched each other. Stop being so impatient.
Yeah, is this a sapphire? It's time for the sapphic tent.
I wanna put on some sunscreen.
Sunscreen shimmer!
Wait, if Sunset is wearing sunscreen, does that mean that they get a darker shade of whatever color a person is? Like, Sunset will get a darker yellow, Twilight will get a darker purple. Like, is that how it works in this world?
Found it!
Oh no, spooky ghost! You're a wizard, Harry!
It's another Jean story. We all know how this ends.
Well, great, she's turning into an X-Men. As if the actual X-Men weren't pussy enough.
I wish I could levitate things, and then I could get my water without... without... doing this. I can't even... Come on. God damn it.
Oh wait, this isn't normal. I forgot. Magic isn't supposed to be normal, even though it totally is. And it has been for 4 movies now.
I think my theory earlier about Twilight's magic was right.
Did you?
Just fart?
This is great! I mean, we've all ponied up before.
Pony up? That sounds so sexual.
How does that sound sexual?
It does.
Maybe it's her!
I love how a recurring subplot is Twilight's own sanity. I hope she gets some help after returning from camp. These symptoms are pretty serious.
This isn't necessarily a bad thing!
This isn't necessarily a bad thing!
I think you're just gonna have to pick it up.
Only in Equestria Girls would Spike be my favorite character.
Choke up like that!
They're all X-Men.
Just here to make sure everyone was headed over to the docks.
Yeah, we get it, fucking slave driver.
Because if there is anything I can do to make this week the best week ever, you just let me know.
Anything?
A blowjob.
People that chipper make me nervous.
I feel ya, Sunset. I feel ya.
It looks like a diamond shining in the sun.
Or alternatively, like a large body of water shining in the sun.
Rarity is the inside of your brain literally just gems and clothes and gems.
Fresh air, the cool breeze, the birds that land on your finger.
I think that only happens to you.
And Snow White.
What? And the skunks that spray in your tents, too?
It only happens to Fluttershy and Disney princesses.
But these are available every day until sunset!
Whoa. I know I'm charming, but you don't have to fall for me.
Oh, fuck off!
Oh my...
I gotta write that down.
Lord knows if she had tripped into the water, he would have already been in the pond.
God, this guy's jokes are cancer. Yeah, and that's coming from the human tumor.
Timber's laying on the smooth moves again, man.
Here at DHX and Hasbro, we'd like to apologize for the previous cringe-inducing joke. Rest assured that the writers will pay for their crimes.
Guess I can't get too jealous, right? After all, she isn't my Twilight.
Ooh, are we gonna get a waifu-stealer showdown?
Fight! 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 Fight!
Oh, Vincent.
Oh, don't worry, Flash. That other Twilight was such a whore.
Jesus, poor Flash. God. Yeah, she'd feel bad for Flash.
Basically, you wanna fuck a horse.
The waifu stealer has had their waifu stolen.
Okay, if I can be genuine for 10 seconds, I really do like how they set up, addressed, and immediately got rid of that cliche jealousy plotline you always see in shitty romantic comedies. Now that that's over... Don't worry, Flash, I'm sure your right hand is still available.
But your Twilight is a princess in Equestria.
And a horse.
Your Twilight is also a horse, and so that's kind of bestiality if you think about it, but don't!
That's where she's gonna spend most of her time.
While being a horse.
Yeah, get over it. You'll never be accepted by the fandom. Except for some people.
So you're saying I just need to get over her?
Kinda, yeah.
Wow, what a good lesson.
Damn.
He needs to get with Sunset again.
No!
And here she is. Sunset Shimmer. The element of brutal honesty.
Let me guess. He's gonna fall for her, even though she's also a pony, so still weird.
Flash Sentry just realized that he has no hopes of getting with Twilight Sparkle. The person that makes him realize this is her humanoid lesbian partner who's realized the same thing. Therefore, Sunset Shimmer and Flash Sentry, who both were banging Twilight, are now gonna bang each other!
But that would make Sunset Shimmer bisexual. Or pansexual.
And gay!
And then Twilight's gonna fall for the other Flash in Equestria. Well, that's not really fair, though, because this Twilight didn't fall for this Flash, and none of the Flash.
You're not pulling any punches.
I don't like pulling punches. Yeah. I like it rough.
I suggest we close down the dock for the remainder of the camp.
Luna, what have they done to you? You used to be an awesome character with a great villain backstory, and now you're just a petty bureaucratic soccer mom. This is why I love Equestria Girls.
The lake's closed. The one wooden platform is broken.
You ask me, this whole dock needs to go.
In fact, I think it should go now.
What the hell, AJ? That's like me punching someone in the face and being like, hey, you should get that black eye checked out. At least when I do it, it's funny.
Oh, that doesn't count, Applejack. Your legs are like cannons.
How weak was that log where Applejack could just kick it over? That's a pretty weak log. Yeah, build a new dock.
Future campers.
What do you guys think?
I think you guys need to seriously work on your posture.
That's some tension, all right.
Sexual tension.
Stop. All right, I'll give it this. There's a lot of moments which only make sense after seeing the end, so that kind of makes this the most rewatchable Equestria Girls movie yet, so... yay?
Wait, the guy pulls up the pole and doesn't fall into the water? I guess they're not load-bearing.
Playing with his wood and pelvic like that?
Yeah, you probably shouldn't be tugging on your wood like that, both biceps.
We can reinforce the foundation,
make it nice and sturdy,
and we can add a wood-carved sign that says Camp Everfree.
And a compartment so I can hide the bodies. What? You forget the most important thing? The wrestling ropes! How are you supposed to have a match if you have no ropes?
And we'll make an absolutely perfect runway for my camp fashion show!
I literally thought she was gonna say something that wasn't fashion.
Grown numb to Rarity's obnoxiously shallow personality.
You say tomato.
I say shut the fuck up.
Adult supervision!
I've never seen anybody so excited for adult supervision.
That's a good line.
Huh. Nice hammer. I made mine.
Really? Well, can your hammer do this?
I learned how to make it from Minecraft.
Lanterns out of solar-powered garden lights.
Lanterns that are run off the power of the sun.
Luna's gonna get pissed!
Pretty crafty there, Timber.
You think that's crafty?
Wait till I see how I get you in my bed. It's true.
I'm like the Picasso of noodles.
Picasso of noodles.
He does appear to be fluent in the art of spaghetti.
Insert penis joke here.
He seems pretty eager to show her what he can do with his noodle.
Oh, he's just showing off. You should see my macaroni art. It's way better.
Ta-da!
Rainbow Dash, that isn't art. That's softcore porn with pasta.
But it's going to be getting dark soon.
Celestia's belt. I can put it in the McCree belt, or is it B-A-N-F?
And realized she was wearing purple socks with a burgundy dress! Ah!
I took an interior design class.
Stop it! Store is too scary!
Can you imagine?
Just wearing a dress.
What do you expect me to say?
With a burgundy, darling! The same color family!
Well, what about yellow and red?
Anyone else have a spooky story?
Once upon a time, there was a pony who got sent to the moon.
The legend of Gaia Everfree.
I'll tell you the legend of Gaia Online.
You were this close to dropping the title. You knew what you were doing.
Many years ago.
Meanwhile, on the Oregon Trail.
Years ago, we actually were white.
A tree branch crashed through the roof of their cabin.
And killed Wilhelm.
Wilhelm, no!
Mouth had jagged rock teeth.
This is the Kim Possible meme all over again. If you pause it right here, her mouth looks like a mustache.
They begged her to let them stay and build their camp.
That's like finding out that there's a murderous mummy in your basement that comes to life every night and it tells you to leave. And you're like, God, but we just moved in!
Here's the story in a nutshell.
I'm pissed off at you!
Yeah, but don't!
I mean, okay, I guess.
Gaia Everfree!
Really, bitch?
Hey, guys! Sorry, didn't mean to scare you.
Then why'd you come out of the bushes?
Wow, Sunset would be great on Brony's React.
Let me guess. That's Gaia Everfree.
Yeah, don't worry about me, just wearing my glowing contact lenses.
You have extra toothbrushes? I forgot mine.
They're trying to make fun of his hygiene, but he's literally asking for a toothbrush.
Forgot mine.
It can't be real.
Yeah, don't be silly.
I mean, sure, we can pony up, grow pony ears and wings, and open portals to different dimensions populated by talking horses, but...
Did you watch the other Equestria Girls movies?
We've had to deal with more than our fair share of those. At the Fall Formal, our musical showcase, the Friendship Gay...
The Friendship Gay, of course! The Friendship Gay. Remember the Friendship Gay?
Oh man, I guess we're going back to this cliche, huh, writers?
No offense!
I hope Slenderman gets her.
I'm always here!
Always here!
What happened?
Ha! I can relate. That's how I wake up too. Except I'm holding a gun. And a sword. And my huge...
Really have to talk about this.
Both really talk about, you know, maybe a signal for when you bring Timber Spruce back to the tent. Usually it's a sock on the outside of the door. You know, whatever. What? It's a joke! It's a joke!
She's not that great at blowing.
It was so weird.
It was unradical.
Are you sure you weren't just a little bit high on some doobies, man?
Derby is the Dovahkiin Fushroda.
Spirit!
I want to see Trixie eating a pine cone. Barbecued, barbecue sauce, anything. I need Trixie eating a pine cone here. She's out in the woods. We need some pine cone action.
Oh, somebody's poisoned the water hole!
What is that? Some kind of oil spill?
My magic juice spilled everywhere.
Camp Everfree needs a runway!
I will celebrate the day Rarity says something that is not related to fashion.
It used to be so simple.
Things used to make sense, and now it doesn't really.
Yeah, that's right. Sing a little I'm Sad song that always seems to make princesses feel better.
Oh, okay.
This could be just the perfect animal I have become AMV or a down with the sickness AMV. You know you see it. It's just like perfect.
Now the darkness rises.
Should we tell her that we can totally hear her?
Nah, she seems stressed out enough.
This is like a depressing anti my past is not today.
Come on, sing some soul.
Midnight in me, yeah.
Mustn't see the midnight in.
All right, I've got nothing. It was a good song.
Twilight, who wanted to know everything about magic, who wants to know everything about everything, all of a sudden, doesn't want to know nothing.
So there was a pretty solid cut where Twilight and Timber were not anywhere to be found. What do you think they were doing?
Spike.
Yeah, I was having the best dream.
I was having a really good wet dream.
Oh man, I can't even catch a break in the human world.
So many squizzards?
And Rarity shall be my bride.
Spikes into interspecies relationships. Wild hops.
Do you have any idea where Twilight could be?
Last time I saw her, she was running off to sing a mopey teen angst song in the forest.
I can track her down.
Alright, Scooby. No. You go with the fucking stoner, I'll go with the two chicks.
Let me show you the way.
You know how many pornos I've seen start like this?
No.
The blushing's super heavy in this movie.
I really wanted to hang out at the mall. I've never told that to anyone. You must be special.
Wow. Really deep, dark secret you got there, buddy.
I mean, it's not that big of a secret. It's more just an opinion you had as a kid. Hey, guys, I have a secret to tell you. I've never told anyone. Come here, I'll tell you the secret. When I was a kid, I hated doing homework.
Yeah, I hated being Amish, but hey, what can you do?
So you're saying is he spent most of his life living in an Amish paradise?
Just the whole time we were talking.
Well, why didn't you say something?
guess we could help Twilight deal with the magic stuff a little later.
She's in the middle of a romantic subplot. Leave her be.
Rock climbing is all about perseverance and trust.
No, it's not. It's all about core strength.
You'll have to wait a little longer, darling.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba, I'm loving it.
Hey, climbing a wall in heels is harder than it looks. Trust me, I know.
Oh my god, Rarity! She's talking about something that's so close! We have a winner! We have a winner! Confetti! Good.
Tabo's fantastic. I love that girl.
See you later.
We get it, you bang.
Twilight. Suddenly reminded of those 2011 memes.
Twilight, there you are. I was looking for you.
Friggin' liar! Liar! Lies and lying.
Crystally dusty stuff here!
That's called crystal meth, and don't touch it. The investigators are gonna want to see it.
It's a little bit stuck.
Applejack, you almost literally killed me!
Earth Pony Power!
That would have hurt! She'd probably be dead! Main 5!
Oh, just the thought of grabbing a rope that's moving that fast. Have you guys ever done that? It's so painful!
No, thank you!
I will be okay.
Don't worry!
Why is this happening? I don't tie girls!
We're not worshipping Satan.
Whoa, 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 whoa! Look at her necklace! I just noticed!
You need more sprinkles, and you need more sprinkles!
Did she just channel Oprah?
Thanks, Oprah.
Hey, look, that's good Oprah joke, ha!
Oh my god, that happens to me too! Except with Molotov cocktails. I didn't expect this to be so relatable.
So, everybody gets like legitimate powers, like force fields, super strength, levitation. If you had a friend that said, hey, my superpower is exploding sprinkies, you're not gonna be friends with them anymore.
Can someone help me out?
Jack Spidewood.
I don't speak chirp.
Fluttershy's not on Twitter, you guys.
She may not speak chirp, but I bet she speaks Japanese. How else can she understand all those yaoi videos? What? It's a joke! It's a joke!
Thank you, Mr. Burns. Of course I can get you a little something to... Did you just talk? But I don't speak chirp. I don't know if you're the only bird I can understand.
Has anybody seen Rainbow Dash? Ow!
Nope, too desperate.
How many hooves am I holding up?
So basically, all of the characters are now Overwatch characters.
Oh, the Trace ahead, talking in the bomb in the boo, woo!
Rainbow Dash is Tracer, Rarity's Reinhardt because of the shield, Pinky's Junkrat. I don't know what Fluttershy is, she can talk to animals. I don't know which character that, Bastion maybe? He talks to a bird.
Basically, by the end of the movie, they're just gonna turn into horses at this rate.
This just seems like the intro to Fantastic Four, where they're all just getting their powers.
I haven't, but Twilight hasn't either.
You liar!
Twilight's...
Stunts,
but...
Sweet cheese and crackers.
How are you not excited about it? Grab wands and start Harry Pottering all over the place.
The towel monster.
He brings you fresh linens when you need him the most. Actually, he's kind of a nice guy.
I got this!
Stop saying that!
And I'm all out of arrows.
Silence, you abomination of an imposter!
Debbie said things!
Derby's voice, so cute!
Maybe we forget about this new magic for a bit.
No, Applejack, don't just do camp activities. Use your powers! That's cooler!
I was oh so excited about the designs I've come up with. She's still part of me. I can feel it.
I can feel Midnight sparkle inside me.
And I think her magic is infecting my friends.
How stupid are you? That's like saying global warming is caused by people.
Then when we light them, mine will be beautiful and delicious!
Makes sense to me.
And you won't be able to eat it, and it won't rise into the air because there's too much weight.
Mine's my face.
You're losing it, Timber.
Mine's my face, because I'm conceited.
Whoa, dude, ego much?
The spoops are getting worse.
Yeah, this is truly the Halloween episode.
You don't seem like yourself tonight.
You've known me for 3 days.
Now, light the candles and say the incantations. Pour the blood across the runes and summon the... Oh, they're just kites.
They're complaining about magic happening, but look, these things are floating without a top. Like, heat, top, push, up. No top, no push.
And at last I see the light. It is like the sky is nude.
Do you want a forest fire? Because that is how you get a forest fire.
Well, for me at least, this wouldn't be the first time the Green Lantern didn't take off.
Did you guys see?
No, no, don't cut away to somebody else! That was comedy gold, and I'm gonna sit here until you acknowledge it!
Yay! They actually did the physics thing with pinkies. I'm very happy.
Did you guys see that? Twilight's lamp and Timber's lamp bumped midair. Symbolism.
Sunset said something.
Say that 5 times fast. Sunset said something. 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 I did it! Oh my gosh!
Twilight?
Blind blot.
Twilight!
Didgeridoo!
Stop in the name of the law!
I saw a guy with a machete over here. Come on, guys!
You don't think it was the spirit, do you?
Hey, Twilight. I think there's nothing wrong with you.
The animation's really good in this movie.
Oh, shut up.
Shut up, Tucker. Shut up. Hey, are you a model or famous actress? Shut.
I have the power of flight. I have the power of super speed.
I can grow my fingernails on command.
Oh, God. That means she can never have sex with anyone without seeing their childhood and inner demons and person they're imagining having sex with.
I've let magic turn me into a monster, too.
If there's anyone that understands fell magic, it's me. Please don't ask me about Warcraft. I have no idea what I'm talking about.
Sunset Shimmer. The element of... brutal empathy?
Ah! Oh, you're not my sister.
I just had to ask you a question.
Why are you hanging out in the woods in the middle of the night?
They're lesbians. What? It's a joke! It's a joke!
Gaia, ever free, ever free, ever free!
Fucking regeneration powers.
Okay, Sokka.
Well, there went half of the film's budget.
That's Avatar.
Yeah, you're right.
Don't worry, I'm gonna protect you!
Come on.
Okay, that's enough of that.
Places, faces, houses. Faces.
I know a shortcut back to the tents.
Oh, you know what that means. Oh, vagina.
He's shitting sparkles.
Oh my God, he's got the ashes of Freddie Mercury in his pocket. That monster.
You know, just because Freddie Mercury is gay doesn't mean that his ashes are automatic.
Have you ever seen any cremated dead gay people?
No.
Then how would you know? Exactly.
I think we just found our Gaia Everfree.
But Gaia Everfree is a Gaia! I'll save you the trouble. Obviously, I pushed the slide stop while wrapping it. Clear and safe wipe.
I like ketchup, man.
The counts too.
She's the best!
The guy she likes is a jerk who's trying to run everybody out of camp.
Or maybe he's just trying to make the story kind of stick with people.
Everyone's being very careful and slow because they're afraid their powers will do something bad, but what's Fluttershy's excuse?
And what if I talk all of the animals' heads off?
Gotta go slow!
Rainbow Dash would hurry up and bring me more wood!
But I didn't even say anything!
This is not a hammering motion.
That is going to be made into a GIF with many different things.
Oh, I think so she's hammering slowly?
Oh, damn, I thought it was something else. I'm like, that's very sexual.
I'm all out of nails.
Oh, here you go! Piggy, no!
Oh, shit! Great!
And then the nails exploded and then everybody died, like some kind of Final Destination incident.
Pinky, you could have killed us!
But I didn't.
Try me!
I was expecting more, like the human version of Smile HD.
So she is on acid.
So we know Pinky is pyro now?
Genuinely terrifying. Oh my gosh.
It's springtime for Hitler and Germany.
That explains so much. What if it turns out that they could actually make things better?
So we're starting a song where Sunset's saying that we should try things that are happening, you know, like everything.
That they could actually make things better.
So you have magic, and it's not that great.
Woo! This is one of the most unrelatable songs I've ever heard, though.
So you won the lottery, and it kinda sucks.
We could potentially do something with these powers.
So you have magic.
You know, I can just imagine Charles Xavier singing this to the X-Men. I'm sorry, like his entire school just singing this.
You got the magic, but it's not really good.
But if you make good, you can build us a god.
Ho! It's time for a song.
I say embrace the magic. Don't hold it in, just let it out.
5 seconds flat?
Shouldn't Twilight be hearing this song? Don't you really think that would be good?
Can you feel with all the colors of the wind?
Rarity is frozen, confirmed.
And it cuts your head off.
So if you listen close, you might make a new friend.
I feel like that line was made for Fluttershy because she has like the most lame magic out of all of them. She can talk to animals, so what?
You know what the song is actually about?
What?
She misses being a unicorn.
Probably does.
Remember when life was great and I could, like, shoot magic out of my face? Now I'm just a teenager.
Because the magic's in the music and the music's in me.
And the magic's part of you even though the music's not that good and the magic's not great, but the music's inside of you and the magic.
Behold, our new god!
Things always seem to get done more quickly when you have a good old-fashioned 80s singing montage.
Too busy getting timbers timber.
No, oh, gross. That was pretty awesome. Don't put that in. And
look at you. That's what Twilight said.
Can we do a run-through for the fashion show on it right this minute? You here might make her embrace the new magic too. Not that she has any.
You liar!
You have to let it go!
Let it go.
Can someone get this f***er a collar with a bell on it or something?
Lost an earring. There it is.
Boy, Sunset, you can really say that earring rocks.
You get it? Hey, it's Boulder.
I really wanted to thank you.
For what?
Thanks for the rough sex. I mean, tough love. Whoops.
Yeah. Cool story, bro.
Oh yes, the ever-so-loved Brad side story that everybody's following with great vigor.
Stop! No! No!
Something wrong?
Something is headed in that direction!
We used to date. I know when something's bothering you.
Wait, wasn't she also, Oh dear. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. That boy has an issue.
So Flash Century has only been into people who were horses at one point.
Flash Century wishes he could get back with me, but I'm a fiery bitch who's never free.
Maybe you and me, we could start over as friends.
Sounds great. I gotta go.
I'm so glad she patted his shoulder.
You know, I can't believe I'm saying this, but I actually like Flash Century now. I really do. He's kind and sensitive and smart. He's awesome. And he should be dating my OC!
Derby's there again. That's great.
Everyone's just patting him. Derby's like, I'll do you.
Cut back to the thing that I did in the other react.
There, there. We're both unappreciated in our own special ways.
He's definitely up to something.
Sunset's convinced about this conflict right now. We don't even know if it's actually the conflict. In fact, there's no sign telling us for sure that it is the conflict. She's assuming a lot. And the issue's not that big of a deal. Like, hey, your boyfriend wants to shut down the camp. Twilight's gonna be like, okay. Oh, hey, it's my parents.
She says to meet her by the rock quarry.
Rock quarry, who called it?
What is that?
The spirit of Halloween.
Spooky, scary skeletons and shivers down your
spine. Spiders! If Skyrim has taught me anything, that cave's gonna be full of trolls, but it's also gonna have some awesome shit at the end of it.
What's going on down there?
I think it's an STD.
Hey, that reminds me of, that scene in Fantasia 2000 where the whale goes floating up in the floating up in the float.
It's all me.
What a twist!
No way!
This is like that cliche where villains reveal their secrets just before attempting to kill the hero. Except in this case, the villain has zero reason to reveal their secrets at all, since they haven't even been exposed yet.
It was I, the evil one!
Gloriosa!
Gloriosa!
It was secretly him! No, it was secretly her! Oh no!
Oh my.
Honey, when I'm done with this place, it won't be called Camp Everfree. It'll be called Camp Neverfree.
Oh my god.
Shut up, that's funny!
Oh. And we'll be going with the plot twist story. I like it. We haven't had one of these since season 2.
I'll give you till the end of the month.
Why is Filthy Rich portrayed as a villain? He's being completely reasonable. Generous, even.
What'll I do?
Like, is she just standing there like... Are you done?
Wouldn't that be a little weird for everyone else? That Sunset Shimmer is just standing there touching her like this? For 2 minutes?
I either think that Sunset's just still holding her and she's like...
Yeah, the whole time.
Bro, she's been like holding onto her arm for like 5 minutes. Gloriosa's gotta be like, stop. Get off!
I saw this movie once. It's called Heavy Metal. Don't trust the glowing green ball. I bet that works for the red stuff too.
Well, those aren't obviously the elements of harmony.
I've been practicing! I can control their power now!
You don't know that for sure.
You can't do this, Poison Ivy. You'll become evil.
Poison Ivy? I thought she was some sort of Captain Planet knockoff.
Yeah, probably.
Oh hey, like the Batman villain, Plant Bitch.
He was talking about you letting go of the magical geodes.
She is not worthy of wielding those geodes.
They're not geodes. Geodes are hollow rocks. They're gemstones.
And they aren't even geodes.
Timber was covering for you.
Yeah, Timber's actually a bro. That was a twist all along.
Too much of it can be dangerous if you can't control it.
Oh, I got this. And I'm going to use it to save my camp.
Gloriosa's motive is on par with a toddler destroying a toy they don't want to share.
I just need more power!
The power!
Great power comes great response to Trillatrix. And who's the red gemstone? It's Sunset Shimmer.
Sorry, girls.
She's gonna save the camp! Stop her!
She became a World of Warcraft villain. Seriously, I don't know anything about Warcraft. Don't ask me.
Eyebrow game's on point.
I like it.
Me too.
She talked about the Gaia, and then she was the Gaia, and then Gaia, and now she's the bad guy. Girl. Female.
Why does every evil chick in this world look the same? It's not like in the real world every evil chick looks like Hillary Clinton.
And then they were lost and forgotten.
They all starve. The end.
Oh no, they're dead.
Rarity looks terrible. She looks like she's wearing a diaper.
Hey, play that funky music, white horse.
Music is my passion.
Told you you'd like it.
Does Applejack's shirt have a boob window? What?
Man, look at all two of those fans watching.
She looks
different.
Yeah, she looks taller.
They really are dumb bunnies.
You'd think after 4 movies, they would know what a demon looks like. She's not taller. She's a demon.
She's real.
Ah, wait, no!
Why are we surprised at this point?
Gloriosa?
There is no Gloriosa. There is only Zool. I mean Gaia Everfree.
That's Gloriosa? Am I going crazy or her feet not touching the ground? Freaky deaky!
Yeah, that's my fourth wall breaking bitch.
Is it really so surprising? 2 of your friends have turned into she-demons.
Whoa. Look at the twigs on that one, huh? Why? It's a joke! It's a joke!
I got this!
Wow. I somehow took that line more seriously when she wasn't evil.
I have waited for the day to send this greedy wolf away.
Isn't this the same plot as The Happening?
I can see a ton of Poison Ivy AMVs made to this.
Stand forever!
I'm actually really digging this villain song. It's pretty good.
Villain song's always the best.
Yeah, it's cool.
Here you have me to protect you within these walls of thorns.
Right here you have me to protect you within these walls of thorns. Can't imagine anything more comforting than that.
Forever free, forevermore.
And my axe.
What are you gonna do with that axe?
He grabs the axe? I thought he was gonna murder her!
Let them come, just let them try. I'm not about to say goodbye.
And then we're gone. Now make them die!
Unleash the magic, free the magic. Unleash the magic, free the magic!
That was pretty good.
That was pretty good.
I'll drink to that.
Yep.
Fuck nature. Nature made smallpox. And the bubonic plague.
And the measles.
It's true.
I'm taking back my complaints. I like that we're making the person who's like, we need to save the land and the forest from the evil greedy guy, is actually seen as the enemy. That's a change of pace. Like, who at this point is not rooting for Filthy Rich?
Why do these kinds of things always happen to us?
Because you're the player characters. That's why. Don't roll a 1.
Save the day!
That's her power. The power of motivation.
And time to make superhero capes!
Ooh, me too! Enough about our wardrobe!
Enough about our wardrobe, Rarity!
They're going furry again, here we go!
Remember when I said they'd be turning into ponies by the end of the movie? No, I mean, I'm not gonna say I was right, but...
Hi.
Do something useful!
Can she only, like, explode sprinkles? Or is it anything? I don't get it.
Save the picnic table!
Dang, Applejack just sees a hole and just shoves her wood into it.
This doesn't look like it's thwarting her plans. It more looks like a mild annoyance at best.
Peter, the picnic table. He was so young.
Yeah, please.
You know what it kind of reminds me of is Dragon Ball Z when Gohan's fighting Cell.
Mm-hmm.
And Gohan won't, like, use his full form to defeat Cell.
Twilight, you have to use your magic.
I don't think I can lift something that big.
Use the force, Luke.
Do or do not. There is no try.
Thanks, Yoder.
Why are you fighting me?
Why are you fighting me? I'm not doing anything bad.
Doing this for you!
I'm doing this for you!
My weekly trips to the spa. To the spa.
I don't know why, it just makes me laugh.
To the spa. But I got this!
Stop saying I got this!
This is when Rainbow Dash goes, yeah, but I'm awesome!
Okay, the phrase, I got this, is being driven into the ground. Stop saying it.
So Fluttershy is not on Twitter, but clearly Glorioso's on Vine.
Midnight Sparkle could take over.
Twilight!
Twilight, you gotta do something! I don't wanna... please.
That isn't your sister. It's someone who's been consumed by equestrian magic.
The moral of just about every Equestria Girls movie is not only that power corrupts, but also, if power corrupts you, it's not your fault. This is a terrible lesson for kids. It would make a great corporate instructional video, though.
That isn't Gloriosa. That's Dark Gloriosa.
Please, Gloriosa, come back! I need you!
Gloriosa! I need to fix this. But I can't do it without you. And after we're done, you can hate me. And that'll be fine. Because I was a horrible brother. And I hurt you, and took some of your money, which you might not have known about. But I was gonna pay you back, I swear.
That's kinda sweet.
He's crying.
Yeah, as a sister.
Yeah.
I need you.
No!
There's only one way to handle a giant tree.
Standing by.
Bring it down.
Cleared hot.
I turn into Midnight Sparkle and only make things worse.
That won't happen. We won't let it.
That won't happen because we'll kill you.
We'll kill you before it does.
At least it's coming out of her forehead and not her crotch.
Sunday, 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 watch Midnight Sparkle and Sci Twi in a cage match, which is her mind.
I have the weirdest boner right now.
You are in charge! You are a light, darling!
This is almost as anime as the last ending from the last movie.
It's very Undertale. I'm with you, kid.
And the magic I carry inside me is the magic of friendship!
As well as lasers, telekinesis, flight, and superhuman durability, but mostly friendship.
Wow, those look familiar.
How convenient. It's like the world was built for them.
Alright, we've got the new villain, which doesn't actually exist. A scene with Derpy to appease the bronies. And now main characters with slightly different outfits, so the collectors have to buy them all over again. Are we forgetting anything else?
Buy our toys!
Buy our merch!
Alright, time for that sweet, sweet merchandise.
Okay, here we go! New merchandise!
Damn, these girls getting RWBY in this bitch.
I'd buy it! Yeah, look at them with their freaking sword wings! Yes! Oh, that is some excellent marketing!
I've got to say, those outfits are terrible. Those are some of the worst designs that they've had in this series so far. Yeah, just terrible. Like, those wings? Why do they look like that? That's awful. And then, like, Twilight's, like, glasses thing, the little visor, what the hell? What are these supposed to be?
Did you steal those glasses from Elton John?
Kind of looks like a cross from Sergeant Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band and the Starlight Express.
Hooray! I'm with my friends!
You'd think at some point the local news would pick up on the giant crystal explosion that happened in the local national park.
You could just feel the radiation raining down upon us!
Hey, look, Celestia is being useless again.
I did not think Celestia and Luna could get any more worthless, and yet...
Gloriosa?
That green thing was her soul.
Return to her after almost losing it to the arcane rituals that she was performing.
This is why you never mess with the dark arts, children.
It's gonna be okay.
Till the government shows up.
You're under arrest.
Yeah, right? You're going to jail.
We're all 1970s hairband rock stars.
Are we not Sailor Moon at this point? Like, are we not?
We've been Sailor Moon for a very long time now.
Could you imagine going out in the town dressed like that? Yeah, you'd look ridiculous.
That's kind of impractical, especially those giant-ass wings.
Yeah, right? I mean, look at that. Just sticking out and bumping into shit.
What'd you say?
Ow! My eye.
Totally go with the other collection I was working on for the camp fashion show!
Oh, Rarity, you... fucking... God damn it.
They just defeated a villain and saved a bunch of lives, and now they have... powers beyond what they could have ever imagined, and she's still talking about her fashion show.
You are a one-track mind, Rarity.
Why can't you focus on one fucking thing?
This is for you, Rarity. Don't read too much into that.
I am so sorry.
We're gonna forgive her. We're gonna forgive her again.
Sorry, I turned into a demon monster and almost destroyed the town. Don't worry, we make it a habit for excusing our children from making horrible, horrible atrocities to other children.
And maybe we can get them to help save it.
Maybe we can get them to sign a petition.
Where would we hold it?
In your prison cell.
A crystal ball?
Crystal bonies?
But I just don't know how we're going to plan a ball by tomorrow.
All right, let me guess. They're all going to say,
we got this!
Recognize this? It's the ninja outfit.
Now I know I'm writing my own song. Find my way to the ending that I want. I'll turn a tragedy into an epic fantasy. Hey,
hey, hey. They got the band back together.
So I guess we have magic now. Or whatever.
This movie has some pretty catchy
tunes. I tried to hear Sunset's outfit rocks. AJ is pretty great. They're all pretty great.
They are all really great.
Well, Pinkie Pie just died.
Does any brand of sprinkles work?
Yet again, exploding sprinkles. What?
But actually, you can make explosive with sprinkles. You just need an oxidizer that will allow them to burn quickly enough. Potassium nitrate's a really good one.
There's some recycled animation. That's the same exact animation that played earlier.
Reusing animation!
I'm starting to see reused shots, guys. Let's not be lazy at the end of the movie.
Steven Spielberg's in the audience!
I'm too busy looking at bulk biceps due to techno Viking.
Wait, look, you shouldn't be upset about that. You should be happy that they're paying you enough money.
A couple of episodes ago for MLP, Filthy Rich was a good guy. So that's just bad timing.
Pretty cool how I saved all those campers.
Ego much?
Wow, way to take the credit, jackass.
Wow, I would just walk away if he said that to me.
It's from those Rubus fruticosis.
Actually, it's Mindy Campum Hollyscythios, a classy botanical, sir.
I'm familiar with the genus.
But I'm not familiar with the word that rhymes with genus. Want to help me out with that?
This is the first movie where they've really, like, gone full forward into the relationships.
That sounds like a goodbye.
Don't worry, you two will be awkwardly bumping into each other in no time.
Yeah, because I'm gonna go to college and make something of my life. I can't be a camp counselor, you fucking scum.
And here I was hoping we'd
gain more friendship and lose some virginity.
Dinner and catch a movie.
Whereas Luke Cage would say, coffee.
Yeah, I really like that.
Thirst levels at maximum!
Well, that cements it. Twilight and what's his face are getting together. I forgot his name again, god damn it.
Oh, don't you fucking do it.
No.
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 Wow, this is so anime.
God damn it, stop it.
Oh.
Oh, why are you gonna cock block him like that, man?
His own sister cock blocked him. Wow.
You guys don't have to worry. This isn't canon.
What is this?
Oh, Jesus, Twilight. Not in the house!
I think the crystals are the source of the superpowers.
What?
The crystals are at our back, boys! That's all we need!
We were meant to have them all along. Me too.
Okay, well, thank you, Twilight, for your input.
Sunset's new dress. Reminds me of my buddies, the Legion of Doom. Ooh, what a rush. What a rush.
Behold the ass crack of Equestria.
Oh shit, sequel setup.
You see that crack right there? It's spewing out sequels.
Ooh, transition and introduction for Equestria Girls. Five!
The plot line for the next movie is leaking out!
Oh no.
Are
Are you guys gonna make another one?
Oh no, not Equestrian Girls 5. Fuck!
Oh, I love it.
It's a rare Pepe.
Oh my gosh, look at the macaroni picture of Twilight and Lovebug. No Twilight left behind! No Twilight left be-
Let's celebrate!
No!
No! Oh, Jesus!
Oh my god!
Somehow this is Rarity's fault.
As we've learned with this movie, don't let Pinky handle anything.
I was nowhere in this movie. I'm very, very disappointed.
Another horrible, horrible movie done.
I don't know, it wasn't so bad.
Wasn't so bad?
I kind of enjoyed it.
Was it so bad?
No.
Nah, yeah, you're right. It was pretty good.
You know, speaking of unsolved mysteries, there is one mystery in this video that is yet to be solved. Who is the person behind that amazing Sailor Moon costume? I guess we'll never know. Either way, I am glad this is over. Oh my god. I can barely breathe in this thing, let alone talk. Hope no one realizes I was just dubbing over all my reactions.